Once upon a time, there was a small kingdom located among the deep forests, where even the unknown was received with joyful smiles. The kingdom could be described in many ways: goodness, harmony, love. Nevertheless, the word light could perfectly describe the image that this kingdom had. A magnificent castle rose in the center. It might be said that this is where its name came from. The Kingdom of Light. Domestic animals, wooden huts, stone paths, all built by the hands of the peasants. However, the castle, a relic of the kingdom, was a miracle, since no peasants knew about its construction. It had limestone piled up to create vast walls, maple wooden windows with steel hardware, and rich stained glass windows in bold colours. These wondrous features included the building at the top, where curly branches encircled the gleam of this kingdom. A gigantic star shone on the top of the building, emitting a light that illuminated the entire town. But this story would not last long in this happiness. The antonym of this kingdom lives on in the neighboring forests of the Kingdom of Light. Here, twisted branches of dead rose bushes grew ruthlessly, killing all life in their path. This kingdom, whose kings were unknown, only wanted to end the Kingdom of Light. There were several attacks with the intention of corrupting the kingdom. But thanks to the strength of the prince, no corruption could set foot in the kingdom. This prince was an orphan with a gift for archery from a young age. When he arrived in the kingdom, the peasants were impressed at how agile and insightful he was at such a young age. He was found by an explorer in the deep forests of darkness. He had an aura of light that made him stand out. How could this young man survive such dangers of the forest? The explorer asked himself. Thus, taking the young man to the town where he presided over the Castle of Light. This young man blended perfectly with the castle, and they guessed he was from there. It was a miracle as well as the existence of the castle. They promoted him to king, since there was none in the kingdom. He insisted, however, to be called a prince, because he, somewhere in that world, knew that his parents were still alive. He defended his kingdom for years and years, and problems began to fade. Nevertheless, a brief memory of his past was still prevalent in his mind. A feeling that provoked nostalgia since his first days in the kingdom. His greatest wish was to be able to appreciate the scent and love of his parents again. One day, he couldn't hold back his feelings. He set off on his way to the forest where the Kingdom of Darkness resided. It was surprising how the prince walked slowly with his elmwood bow through the streets of the kingdom. All the peasants close to him stared at him. Finally, he left without a trace, filling the kingdom with whispers and rumors with no whereabouts. Regret and pain soon manifested in the prince's chest, since as soon as he walked into the dark woods, he thought that his parents couldn't possibly have lived there. He ignored his dreary sensation and continued his way. He felt as if millions of gazers were watching his movements. His muscles were weakened, and simply taking a step was hard to do. But something was not right. He began to experience feelings that could never manifest. He started to get corrupted.
But you know it happened quite.